Is aging inevitable? What if it's not? What does science say about it? The answers might surprise you. Can we really stop aging? Perhaps we're much closer than we all think. Hello and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to explore one of humanity's oldest and most profound questions. Can we actually reverse aging? Or, to put it more realistically, can we slow down aging, reduce its effects, and extend our healthy lifespan? What is aging? Before we can talk about reversing or slowing aging, we need to understand what aging actually is. For most people, aging is about wrinkled skin, graying hair, decreased energy, and an increased risk of diseases. But on a cellular and molecular level, aging is far more complex. Over time, our cells accumulate damage, lose the ability to repair themselves, and experience shifts in their metabolism and gene expression. Key hallmarks of aging include the shortening of telomeres, those protective caps at the ends of our chromosomes, DNA damage, changes in how our genes are read, epigenetic changes, accumulation of misfolded proteins, mitochondrial dysfunction, and chronic inflammation. The balance between damage accumulation and repair gradually tips, leading to what we recognize as the aging process. Understanding these core mechanisms sets the stage for potential interventions that could slow, halt, or even partially reverse certain aspects of aging. Key theories of aging. Scientists have proposed many theories to explain why and how we age. 1. Free radical theory. Once popular, this theory suggested that reactive oxygen species, free radicals, generated by our metabolism damage cells, accelerating aging. While we now know it's more nuanced, oxidative stress still plays a role in aging. 2. Telomere shortening. Each time a cell divides, telomeres get shorter. When they become critically short, the cell can no longer divide and enters a state known as senescence. This contributes to tissue dysfunction over time. 3. Epigenetic changes. As we age, the patterns of chemical markers on our DNA, like methyl groups, change, altering gene expression. This can lead to cells losing their identity and function. 4. Loss of proteostasis. Over time, cells become less efficient at clearing damaged proteins and organelles. Accumulation of this junk impairs cellular function. Aging likely results from a combination of these factors, rather than a single root cause. Understanding these mechanisms is crucial for developing effective anti-aging strategies. Historically, the quest for youth and longevity has led humans to pursue mythical fountains of youth, magical elixirs, and secret potions. Modern science, however, began making significant strides in the mid-20th century. Research on simple organisms, like yeast, fruit flies, and the nematode worm C. elegans, revealed that genetic modifications could extend lifespan dramatically. These breakthroughs hinted that aging is not just a passive, inevitable decline, but may be modifiable. Later, studies on mice showed that certain genes, when altered, could increase longevity. More recently, research on human cells, advanced genomic and epigenetic profiling, and sophisticated animal models have provided deeper insights. Today, we regard aging as a biological process that could be targeted and manipulated, at least to some degree. Telomeres act like protective caps at the ends of our chromosomes, preventing our genetic material from unraveling. Every cell division shortens these telomeres, and once they become too short, the cell stops dividing and becomes old. Some cells, like reproductive cells, produce an enzyme called telomerase that can rebuild telomeres, granting them a kind of longevity. Cancer cells exploit this mechanism to become effectively immortal. For anti-aging research, controlling telomerase has long been a goal. If we could safely maintain telomere length, we might slow down cellular aging. But there's a significant caveat. Activating telomerase might increase the risk of uncontrolled cell growth, i.e., cancer. Researchers continue to investigate how to balance telomerase activity to slow aging without increasing cancer risk. It's a delicate dance and remains an ongoing area of exploration. Epigenetics refers to modifications that influence when and how genes are expressed, without changing the underlying DNA sequence. Over time, patterns of DNA methylation and histone modification shift, disrupting normal gene expression. Scientists have developed epigenetic clocks that can estimate biological age based on these patterns. Intriguingly, some studies suggest that epigenetic changes can be reversed. Research with so-called Yamanaka factors, four transcription factors that can reprogram adult cells into pluripotent stem cells, has shown that cells in older mice can be rejuvenated to a more youthful state. While we are far from applying this technique in humans on a large scale, the proof of concept is there. Epigenetic reprogramming might one day be used to reverse certain aspects of cellular aging. Sirtuins are a family of enzymes involved in cellular stress responses, DNA repair, and metabolic regulation. They've attracted significant attention in aging research. To function optimally, sirtuins require a molecule called NAD+, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. Unfortunately, NAD+ levels decline with age, reducing sirtuin activity and overall cellular health. Compounds that boost NAD+, like nicotinamide riboside, NR, or nicotinamide mononucleotide, NMN, have extended lifespan in animal studies. They improve mitochondrial function, enhance DNA repair, and improve metabolism. Early human trials are underway, but it's not yet conclusive. Still, NAD+ restoration represents a promising avenue in anti-aging research, potentially helping cells maintain youthful function for longer. Dietary interventions significantly influence lifespan and health span. Caloric restriction, CR, consuming slightly fewer calories than needed, has been shown in various species to increase lifespan. CR triggers cellular defense mechanisms, improves insulin sensitivity, reduces oxidative stress, and enhances DNA repair processes. While long-term CR effects in humans aren't fully understood, small studies indicate improvements in heart health, metabolic markers, and possibly markers of aging. Intermittent fasting, another dietary strategy, may yield similar benefits by giving cells periods of low nutrient intake, which encourages cellular cleanup and repair processes. Although we need more research to understand the long-term impacts in humans, these strategies illustrate how lifestyle can influence the aging process at a cellular level. Some existing drugs show promise for slowing aging. Metformin, a widely used type 2 diabetes medication, has been associated with reduced risks of cancer and cardiovascular disease in diabetic patients. This led to the TAME trial, which aims to see if metformin can slow aging in non-diabetic older adults. Rapamycin, an immunosuppressant drug, inhibits MTOR, a key protein that regulates cell growth and metabolism. Animal studies show rapamycin can extend lifespan in multiple species. But rapamycin's long-term immunosuppressive effects in humans raise safety concerns. Still, rapamycin and related compounds are exciting areas of research, hinting that carefully modulating cellular growth signals could slow aging. More anti-aging compounds are being tested in labs worldwide, striving to replicate the benefits of interventions like CR without side effects. Our tissues rely on stem cells to repair damage and maintain function. As we age, our stem cell pools shrink and their regenerative capacity declines. Researchers are exploring ways to rejuvenate stem cells or replace damaged tissues with lab-grown or donor-derived cells. Some experiments show that transferring young plasma to older mice can improve cognitive and muscular function, suggesting that certain factors in young blood can boost tissue repair processes. While these findings are preliminary, they reveal that aging isn't always a one-way street. Some aspects might be reversed or mitigated. Still, implementing stem cell therapies in humans faces ethical, safety, and efficacy challenges. The potential is enormous, but we have a long road ahead before such treatments are routine. Tools like CRISPR-Cas9 allow precise edits to DNA. This could enable us to fix genetic mutations that accelerate aging or enhance genes that promote longevity. However, gene editing in humans raises profound ethical, social, and safety questions. What if we could engineer ourselves to age more slowly, or resist age-related diseases. While still in early stages, gene editing could become a powerful anti-aging tool in the future. For now, much of this remains theoretical. Safety, off-target effects, and long-term consequences are major hurdles. But the vision of using gene editing to slow aging or prevent age-related disease is no longer purely science fiction. No matter how advanced our therapies become, lifestyle choices will always matter. Regular exercise helps maintain muscle mass, bone density, cardiovascular health, and metabolic balance. It supports mitochondrial function and even influences gene expression. Good sleep is equally essential. During sleep, the body repairs DNA damage, balances hormones, and clears metabolic waste, including in the brain. Chronic stress accelerates aging by maintaining elevated levels of cortisol and inflammation. Reducing stress through meditation, yoga, therapy, or simple breathing exercises can slow this process. Social connections, mental stimulation, and a sense of purpose also support healthier aging, improving both lifespan and health span. Aging isn't just a cellular phenomenon, it's also social and psychological. People who remain socially active, have strong support networks, engage in meaningful activities, and maintain a positive outlook tend to age more gracefully. Studies suggest that mental and emotional well-being can influence inflammation, immune function, and overall health. On the other hand, chronic loneliness, depression, and anxiety can worsen physical health and potentially accelerate aging processes. As we think about anti-aging strategies, we should also consider mental health, community support, and emotional well-being as integral parts of the puzzle. If average lifespans increase significantly, societies will need to adapt. Retirement systems, healthcare costs, job markets, intergenerational relationships, and resource allocation would all be impacted. There are important ethical questions. Should anti-aging treatments be accessible to everyone, or will they exacerbate inequalities? How do we balance prolonged life with the environment, resource use, and sustainability? We also need to consider the psychological implications of a significantly longer life. Would it truly be better? Or could it bring unforeseen challenges? The aim should not be simply adding years to life, but adding life to those years, ensuring that longer lives remain meaningful, healthy, and fulfilling. At this point, fully reversing aging remains out of reach. But extending the healthy portion of our lives, the health span, is becoming more plausible. We may soon see drugs or supplements that mimic the effects of caloric restriction, compounds that safely modulate epigenetics, and interventions that support stem cell health. In the long term, gene editing, advanced cell therapies, and epigenetic reprogramming might allow an 80-year-old to live with the vitality of someone decades younger. The progress we've made over the last decade gives reason for optimism. Yet we must proceed with caution and humility, carefully evaluating safety and long-term effects. It's important to remain realistic. Results in animal models don't always translate directly to humans. The booming anti-aging market is filled with hype, and not all claims are supported by solid science. Always rely on reputable sources, peer-reviewed research, and expert opinion when considering anti-aging interventions. We must also be vigilant about potential downsides. Slowing aging might inadvertently increase cancer risk or other health issues. We need more data, long-term studies, and interdisciplinary collaboration to ensure that any anti-aging treatment is both safe and effective. While groundbreaking therapies may still be years away, there's plenty we can do now. Regular exercise, a balanced diet, incorporating strategies like intermittent fasting if appropriate, ensuring good sleep hygiene, and managing stress, all contribute to healthier aging. Monitoring health markers, seeking medical advice, and making gradual lifestyle improvements can help maintain vitality as we get older. These smaller steps may one day synergize with advanced anti-aging treatments, offering us longer and healthier lives. By optimizing what we can now, we create a solid foundation for future interventions. So, can we reverse aging? Not yet. At least not in the most literal sense. But we can slow it down, reduce its harmful effects, and possibly push back the boundaries of old age. The field of aging research is advancing at a remarkable pace. New discoveries, therapies, and technologies may soon make what seemed like science fiction a reality. Nevertheless, such advances will bring complex ethical questions, social adjustments, and a need for cautious implementation. The ultimate goal is not just to live longer, but to live better. A longer life that's healthy, happy, purposeful, and fulfilling. That's the real target. Thank you for watching. If you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comments below. Until next time, stay curious and take care.